Good evening, brethren. We are sorry for the technical hiccup. We'd like to proceed now with our study on the double intercession of Christ. Because of time, we will look at straight away how God in ancient Israel, dealt with diseases. Let us look at Leviticus 14, verse 10. Because it was a sanctuary.
And 3 chief deals of fine flour for a meat offering, and one.
Male lamps, they were a symbol of the intercession, which is masculine. And this female lamp was also a symbol of a feminine intercessor,
right.
Because there was no need for saying two lamps, two male and one female, for the work of intercession. Okay, let's read it.
Verse 11.
Yes.
And the priest that maketh him clean,
mm-hmm,
shall present the man that is to be made clean,
mm-hmm,
and those things before the Lord,
mm-hmm,
at the door of the temple of the congregation.
Yes.
And the priest shall take one hill lamb,
mm-hmm,
and offer him for a trespass offering,
mm-hmm,
and the log of oil.
Yes.
And wave them for a wave offering,
yes,
before the Lord.
Yes. So you see, it was specified that this the gender of the animals is not necessary. They would have specified, they would just have said a lamb,
yeah.
Whether male or female.
Yes.
But here they specified two males, one female.
Yeah.
Okay, let's also look at another example. Can you go to verse 21 to see if someone was poor, how were they treated? Yes.
John 1.
Yes.
And if he be poor, mm-hmm, he cannot get so much. Then he shall take one lamb, mm-hmm, for a trespass offering to be waved.
So one lamb was required to someone who was poor for a trespass offering.
Yeah.
Yes.
To make an atonement for him.
Yeah.
And 1/10 deal of fine flour,
mm-hmm,
mingled with oil for a meat offering.
Yes.
And a log of oil.
Yes.
And 2 turtle doves,
mm-hmm,
and 2 young pigeons.
Okay. Turtle doves, they always move in pairs,
right,
a male and a female.
Yeah.
So the law said for the poor, bring one lamb and 2 turtle doves, a male and a female. Why 2? Yes.
Or 2 young pigeons.
Or 2 young pigeons. They also move in pairs, a male and a female. Yes.
Such as he is liable to get.
Yes.
And the one shall be a sin offering,
mm-hmm,
and the other a burnt offering.
Right. So one was for a sin offering and the other one was for a burnt offering. So obviously the one for a sin offering was to be killed.
Yes.
While the one for the burnt offering would be set free. Okay, let's move on.
And he shall bring them on the 8th day,
mm-hmm,
for his cleansing.
Yes.
Unto the priest.
Yes.
Unto the door of the tabernacle of the congregation, right, before the Lord.
Yes.
And the priest shall take the lamb,
mm-hmm,
of the trespass offering,
mm-hmm,
and the log of oil.
Mm-hmm.
And the priest shall wave them for a wave offering before the Lord.
Yes.
And he shall kill the lamb of the trespass offering.
Mm-hmm.
And the priest shall take some of the blood of the trespass offering,
mm-hmm.
and put it upon the tip of the right ear,
yes.
of him that is to be cleansed,
mm-hmm.
and upon the thumb of his right hand,
mm-hmm.
and upon the great toe of his right foot.
Mm-hmm.
And the priest shall pour off the oil into the palm of his own left hand.
Mm-hmm.
And the priest shall sprinkle with his right finger some of the oil that is in his left hand, mm-hmm. seven times before the Lord.
Yes.
And the priest shall put off the oil that is in his hand, mm-hmm. upon the tip of the right ear,
mm-hmm.
of him that is to be cleansed,
mm-hmm.
and upon the thumb of his right hand, and upon the great toe of his right foot, and upon the place of the blood of the trespass offering.
Yes. And what verse is that?
Verse 29.
Okay. So a poor person was supposed to bring the one lamb and the two turtle doves.
Yes.
Now you can proceed with it at your own spare time, but you find that the male was killed, the male turtle dove was killed, while the female was dipped in the blood of this male turtle dove and was set free to go.
Mm-hmm.
So the other one was not killed. The female was not killed. It was the male that was killed.
Yeah.
That process was telling us of the double intercession that was in the Old Testament.
Yeah.
Yes. Let's move on to Numbers 19 from verse 1 to 4.
Verse 1.
Yes.
And the Lord spake unto Moses and Aaron, saying,
mm-hmm.
This is the word of the Lord which the Lord commanded,
mm-hmm.
saying, speak unto the children of Israel, that they bring thee a red heifer without spot,
mm-hmm.
wherein is no blemish,
yes.
and upon which never came yoke.
Mm-hmm. A red heifer is a female.
Yeah.
Is a cow. So a red heifer, why specifically a cow? Why a female?
Right?
Mm-hmm. Why not a bull?
Mm-hmm.
Why not just bring us any cattle?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
But here they are specifying a female,
uh-huh.
meaning that the male and female have to do with the intercession of, had to do with the intercession of ancient Israel.
Right.
And they represented the intercession of spiritual Israel as well. As Christ died on the cross.
693.3.
Yes.
The worlds had fallen,
mm-hmm.
and the heavenly angels had watched with intense interest as the conflict drew to its close.
Mm-hmm.
Satan and his confederates of evils,
mm-hmm.
the legions of apostasy, watched intently,
mm-hmm.
this great crisis in the work of redemption.
Yes.
The powers of good and evil waited to see what answer would come up to Christ thrice repeating prayer.
Mm-hmm.
Angels long to bring relief to the divine sufferer,
mm-hmm.
but this might not be.
Mm-hmm.
No way of escape was found for the Son of God.
Mm-hmm.
In this awful crisis, when everything was at stake, when the mysterious cup trembled in the hand of the sufferer, the heaven opened, and the light shone forth amid the stormy darkness of the crisis hour, and the mighty angel, who was the presence of God, occupied the position from which Satan failed, came to the side of Christ.
Okay, just stop there. So now we are seeing that when Satan fell in heaven, he was replaced by a mighty angel.
Yeah.
And this mighty angel, you notice as you proceed that it was Gabriel,
yeah.
who replaced the mighty angel, who replaced Satan. So now, Satan was not happy with the mighty angel who replaced him, like any other person would not be happy to be replaced, isn't it?
Yeah.
So he was not happy with this mighty angel. Mm-hmm. Okay, let's move on.
In the head of the sufferer, the heavens opened.
Yes.
The light shone forth coming in stormy darkness,
mm-hmm.
this hour,
mm-hmm.
and the mighty angel
mm-hmm.
who stands in the presence of God,
mm-hmm.
occupied
yeah.
came to the center.
So, came. Do you see the mighty angel also came
yeah.
when Christ was suffering yeah. and when Christ needed sympathy, needed comfort, the mighty angel came
yes.
to comfort and to strengthen Christ.
Yeah.
And the mighty angel was seen to as the, his presence, I mean her presence, was seen to glorify the place.
Yeah.
Yes.
The angel
mm-hmm.
came not to take the cup of from Christ's hand,
yeah.
but to strengthen him to drink it.
Yes.
With the assurance of the Father's love.
Yes.
He came to give power to the divine human supply.
Mm-hmm.
He pointed him to the heavens,
yeah.
telling him of the souls that would be saved as the result of his sufferings.
This is what Christ needed at this hour
yeah.
to be comforted, to be reminded of the benefits of his suffering, that many people would be saved by this suffering.
Yeah.
So it was only Gabriel who could do this comforting.
Yeah.
Yes.
He assured him
mm-hmm.
that his Father is greater mm-hmm. and more powerful than Satan.
Yes.
That his death would result in the utter discomfiture of Satan.
Yes.
And that the kingdom of this world would be given to the saints of the Most High.
Mm-hmm.
He told him.
Amen. That the kingdom of this world will be given to the saints of the Most High.
Amen.
Do you see? It was a very important occasion that Gabriel took to comfort Christ and remind him of all the benefits of his suffering.
Amen.
So that was the time that Christ was strengthened to continue with the plan of salvation. Yes.
He told him
mm-hmm.
that he would see of the travail of his soul
mm-hmm.
and be satisfied.
Amen.
For he would see a multitude of human race
mm-hmm.
saved.
Yes.
Eternally saved.
Yes. So it only needed someone who was sincere, with the right words, the right comforting words, to come and stand with Christ. And that one was the only comforter who was Gabriel,
yeah.
the mighty angel. So we'll see who Gabriel is.
Yeah.
Yes. Let's move on. Let's go to
7.9.2.
7.9.2.
Yes. And the hope was a great effect
mm-hmm.
for the angel from heaven.
Mm-hmm.
Clothed with the panoply of God,
mm-hmm.
this angel left the heavenly courts.
Yes,
the bright beams of God's glory went before him
mm-hmm.
and illuminated his pathway.
Mm-hmm.
His countenance was amazing, and his raiment was as normal.
Do you see how this mighty angel appeared?
Yeah.
Yes, the countenance was
like lightning.
Like lightning, yeah. And his
raiment. White as snow,
yes.
And for fear of him,
mm-hmm.
the keepers did shake
mm-hmm.
and became as dead men.
Yeah. So to those who kept the grave of Christ, they got frightened just by seeing a Gabriel
yeah.
coming to the tomb. Yes. Yeah.
Now priests and rulers
mm-hmm.
were in the power of your God.
Mm-hmm.
Brave soldiers
mm-hmm.
that have never been afraid of human power or and now as captives taken without sword and spear.
Yes.
The face they look upon is not the face of mortal warrior.
Mm-hmm.
It is the face of the mightiest of the Lord's host.
Amen.
Mm.
You see, he was called the mightiest
yeah.
of the Lord's host.
Amen.
That was Gabriel.
Yeah.
Yes.
This messenger
mm-hmm.
is he who fills the position from which Satan fell.
Do you see that?
Yes.
Gabriel occupied the position that Satan
fell. Yeah.
Whereas Christ stood by his position. So the other position that Lucifer occupied was taken by the mightiest
yes.
of all the angels. Yes.
It is he
yes.
who on the hills of Bethlehem
mm-hmm.
proclaimed
Christ. Amen. He says, it is he, of course, because the inspiration wrote there, the light hadn't fully come to show the gender of Gabriel.
Yes.
So this is why they wrote he, and this is why Paul in other scriptures says it for the Holy Spirit and the Holy Ghost, because they didn't know their gender.
Yeah.
But light was to be revealed through the prophets. Mm-hmm. And today we know that Gabriel is feminine, is the Holy, a Holy Ghost. So let's move on.
It is he.
It is she.
It is she.
Yes.
Who owns the hills of Bethlehem?
Who owns the hills of Bethlehem? Yes.
Proclaimed Christ's birth.
Yes. She proclaimed Christ's birth. Yes.
The earth trembles at his approach.
Yeah.
The host of darkness flee.
Yes.
And as she rolls away the stone, heaven seems to come down to the earth.
Yeah.
The soldiers see him removing the stone as he would a pebble, and fear him, cry, Son of God, come forth. Thy Christ falls there.
Yes.
They see Jesus come forth from the grave, and hear him proclaim over the ram's sepulchre.
Okay, let's move on to 788.2, 2 and 3. 788.2 and 3.
The woman who had stood by the cross of Christ waited and watched for the hours of the Sabbath to pass.
Yes, that is on the day Christ died, yes?
On the first day of the week, very early, they made their way to the tomb, taking with them precious spices to anoint the Savior's head, to anoint the Savior's body. They did not think about his rising from the dead. The sun of their hope had set, and night had settled down on their hearts. As they walked, they recounted Christ's works of mercy and his words of comfort. But they remembered not his words, I will see you again.
Yeah.
Ignorant of what was even then taking place, they drew near to the garden, saying, as they went, we shall roll us away the stone from the door of the sepulchre.
Yes.
They knew that they could not remove the stone, yet they came on their way.
Yes.
And lo, the heavens were suddenly alight. Not from the rising sun. The earth trembled. They saw that the great stone was rolled away. The grave was empty.
Yes.
The woman had not all come to the tomb from the same direction. Mary Magdalene was the first.
Okay, you're now on page.
On page 788.
Point three. Yes. Can you read?
They look into the tomb, and again they hear the wonderful news. Another angel in human form is there.
Okay, so do you see that? They are seeing an angel in human form.
Yeah.
What does that tell us? That angels can take any form.
Yes.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
So that they are able to be seen by human beings.
Yeah.
So they take the human form. And in this case, they took a form of a man.
Yeah.
So those who think that when they meet a man, they may say it's a man when it's actually a female.
Yes.
So they take any form. You remember the dove issue? They can take the form of a dove. They come in form of a dove. They can take any form. They are able to change themselves so that they are able to be recognized without causing a panic. Yes.
Another angel in human form is there.
So there were two angels by the graveside. Remember, we said, we got a quotation that there are four angels, right?
Mm-hmm.
Christ and the Holy Ghost, and these other two that we are seeing, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's move on.
He is not here. He is not here.
Yeah.
But he is risen.
Yes.
Remember how he spake unto you when he was yet in Galilee, saying, the Son of Man shall be delivered into the hands of the sinful men.
Okay, just leave it there. Now go to 4 BC 11, 73.3. 4 BC
1173.3. Yes. 1173.3. Yes. By this, we say that heavenly agencies have to connect with hindrances before the purpose of God is fulfilled in its time.
Yes.
The king of Persia was controlled by the highest of all evil angels.
Yeah.
He refused, as did Pharaoh, to obey the word of the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Gabriel
mm-hmm.
declared
mm-hmm.
he withstood me 21 days by his representation against the Jews.
You see now?
Yeah.
Gabriel is being withstood by the prince.
Yeah.
Yes.
Gabriel
mm-hmm.
declared
mm-hmm.
he withstood me 21 days
yeah.
by his representations against the Jews.
Yes.
But Michael
mm-hmm.
came to his help.
Mm-hmm.
And then he
So do you see Gabriel was helped by Michael?
Yes.
Yeah.
Now we see the names are coming up.
Yeah.
Yeah. We know there's the Holy Ghost with Gabriel. Yeah.
Yes.
And Gabriel has her own angel.
Mm-hmm.
And we have Christ. And Christ has his angel, also called Michael the Archangel,
yeah.
right?
Yeah.
So there are four of them that are used by God in this work. But in the intercession, we have Christ and the Holy Ghost. That those are the ones that we have seen in the sanctuary on earth or in ancient Israel. They were using representatives of Christ and the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
Now let's move on to Luke chapter. Let's go to Luke 24:7.
Verse 27.
Mm-hmm.
And beginning at Moses
yes.
and all the prophets,
mm-hmm.
he expounded unto them in all the scriptures
mm-hmm.
the things concerning himself.
Okay, so do you see from Moses, God was choosing prophets.
Yeah.
And this school of prophets is in the line of the spirit of prophecy.
Yes.
And the spirit of prophecy is, who is behind the spirit of prophecy? The Holy Ghost.
Yeah. Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Let's also look at 1 Peter 1 verse 11. 1 Peter 1, verse 11.
Searching what
mm-hmm.
or what manner of time the Spirit of Christ, which was in them, did signify.
Mm-hmm.
When he testified beforehand
yes.
the sufferings of Christ
mm-hmm.
and the agony and the glory that would that should follow.
Mm-hmm. So the Spirit of Christ is the Spirit of prophecy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And the disciples, they received this spirit of prophecy.
Yes.
Do you see that?
Yeah.
The ancient people also had this spirit of prophecy from Moses. We are seeing them being given that spirit of prophecy.
Yeah.
Let's go to CCH 58, 54.1. Yes.
As Daniel's prayer is going forth,
mm-hmm.
the angel Gabriel
mm-hmm.
comes sweeping down from the heaven courts
mm-hmm.
from the heavenly courts to,
yes.
to tell him that his petitions are heard
yeah.
and answered.
Right. So do you see God sends the swiftest angel,
yeah.
the mightiest angel, who is Gabriel? They come down to give instructions.
Yeah.
To give a message to Daniel
yeah.
during the ninth hour of prayer.
Yeah.
So this mighty angel, so when we talk of the mighty angel, we must always remember the mighty angel who comes to instruct God's children.
Yes.
Right? Let's look at Genesis 1. Genesis 1.
verse 26.
Yeah.
And God said,
mm-hmm.
let us make man in our image,
mm-hmm.
after our likeness.
Yes.
And let them have dominion over the fish of the sea,
mm-hmm.
and over the fowl of the air.
So we see Christ having dialogue with someone. Let us make
man,
yes. man in our yeah. image. So he didn't create man alone. Mm-hmm. He had someone whom he says, let's make man in our mm-hmm. image. And what did they create?
So God created man mm-hmm. in his own image.
Yes.
In the image of God
uh-huh.
created him.
Yes.
Male and female
mm-hmm.
created him.
Amen. Male and female so, created he,
them. Yes.
In whose image? In yeah. God's in image, image, isn't it?
Yeah.
So we see that they had the form and features of God.
Yeah.
Let's see if this is true.
Yeah.
That they the form and feature
of God.
Of God. Let's go to Great Controversy. Page 6, 44. 644.6. Yes.
In the lives of all who reject truth, mm-hmm. there are moments when conscience awakens,
mm-hmm.
when memory presents the torturing recollection of a life of hypocrisy,
mm-hmm.
and the soul is aroused.
Okay, go to the last, towards 6:45.
Those who would have destroyed Christ and his faithful people now witnesses the glory which rests upon them.
Mm-hmm.
In the midst of the exclaimed, Lord, this is our God. We have waited for him and go, we shall be saved.
Go down where it was created in form and division.
In the beginning, man was created in the likeness of God.
Yes. So man was created in the likeness of God. Yes.
Not only in character.
Yeah.
But in form and feature.
Not only in character, but in form and feature. So we are told in Genesis 1 that God created Adam and Eve in the image of the creators. So we know that the creators must be male and female. So that image of our body.
Yeah.
It must have male and female.
Yes.
Right? So if we look at Proverbs chapter 8, it will show us that these people who were the creators who were creating Adam and Eve must have been our intercessors.
Yeah.
Let's read from verse 1. Yes.
Doth not wisdom cry,
mm-hmm.
and understanding put forth their voice?
Yes. So we know there is a female who has a voice,
yeah.
who is called wisdom,
yeah.
right? Who cries,
yeah.
right? Let's move on.
She standeth in the top of five places.
Yes.
By the way, in the places of the paths.
Yes.
She cried at the gates of the entry of the city,
mm-hmm.
at the coming in and at the doors.
Yes.
Unto you, O men,
mm-hmm.
I call,
mm-hmm.
and my voice is to the sons of men.
Yeah.
O ye simple,
mm-hmm.
understand wisdom.
Mm-hmm.
O ye fools, be of an understanding heart.
Yes. So, you see, this woman, or this female called wisdom, is questioning us children.
Yes.
Let's go to verse 14.
Counsel is mine.
Yes.
And sound is wisdom. And sound wisdom.
Counsel and sound wisdom are from here.
Yes.
Right? So this is why you find God sending Gabriel to counsel, to give an answer to Daniel.
Yeah.
Okay, let's move on up to
counsel is mine.
Yes.
And sound wisdom.
Mm-hmm.
I am understanding.
Mm-hmm.
I am strength.
Mm-hmm. So, do you see now why she's got a mighty angel.
Yeah.
She's got strength.
Yeah.
Yes, and she's got wisdom. She's got understanding. She's got counsel. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Mm-hmm. By me, mm-hmm. kings reign.
Yes.
And princes mm-hmm. decree justice.
Yes.
By me, mm-hmm. princes rule.
Mm-hmm.
And nobles, even all the judges of the earth.
Mm-hmm.
I love them that love me.
This is why Solomon, when he was asked what he wanted, he actually said, I want what?
Wisdom.
Wisdom.
Yeah.
And he was the wisest king that reigned. And that wisdom. So let's go to verse 30.
Verse 30.
Yes.
Then I was by him.
Okay. Maybe start a little bit up.
And lead in the way of righteousness.
Yes.
In the midst of the paths of judgment.
Yeah.
That I may cause those that love me mm-hmm. to inherit substance,
mm-hmm.
and I will fill their treasures.
Yes.
The Lord possessed me in the beginning of his way.
So, can you say that this woman says, the Lord possessed me in the beginning of his way? Yes.
Before his works of old.
Before his works of old. So, it could not have been one of the concubines of Solomon, as other people have said.
Yeah.
But it is someone divine. Who was possessed by the Lord before the ways of old, which is before the world was created.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
I was set up from everlasting.
Yes.
From the beginning.
She is saying she was set up from everlasting. Now, if she was set up from everlasting and she calls us children, so she is our mother. Mm-hmm. Do you see that?
Yes.
Just like Christ in Isaiah 9 verse 6, says to us a son is born, the everlasting father.
Mm-hmm.
So Christ also is called everlasting father, and the Holy Ghost is called wisdom, and it's called Gabriel, and he's called the everlasting mother. Right? Mm-hmm. Let's move on.
I was set up from everlasting,
yes,
from the beginning,
mm-hmm.
or ever the earth was.
Yeah.
When they were not dead. I was brought forth.
Yes.
When they were not found in
the This world. Is clear scriptures.
Right.
To anyone who loves the truth.
Yeah.
It is clear. It's a female who is telling us she was there before it was created.
Yeah.
And she was with Christ. She is also ever from everlasting.
Yeah.
Just like Christ is from everlasting. Everlasting means it has a beginning, but no ending.
Yeah.
But eternal, just like God the Father in heaven is eternal, he has no beginning and no ending. So here we have two who are claiming that they are from everlasting.
Yeah.
Yes?
Before the mountains were settled,
mm-hmm.
before the hills was I brought forth.
Yes.
While as yet he had not made the earth,
yes,
nor the fields,
yeah,
nor the highest part of the dust of the earth.
Mm-hmm.
When he prepared the heavens,
mm-hmm.
I was there.
She was there when the heavens were being prepared, yes?
When he set a compass above the face of the depth,
mm-hmm.
when he established the clouds above,
mm-hmm. yes?
When he strengthened the fountains of the deep,
yes?
When he gave to the sea his decree,
mm-hmm.
that the water should not pass his commandment,
mm-hmm.
when he appointed the fountains of the earth,
mm-hmm.
then I was by him,
yes?
As one brought up with him,
yes?
And I was daily his delight.
Amen.
Rejoicing before him.
Amen.
Amen.
So she is telling us the relationship that she had with Christ.
Amen.
Almost similar to that of husband and wife.
Amen.
Of two people who love each other, male and female. This doesn't happen between males and male and male.
True.
But between male and female.
Female.
Right. And she has already said it's a woman.
Yeah.
That's why it says she, right?
Yes.
So it's a woman. So she's telling us she was there when God was being created.
Yeah.
Therefore, when Christ was creating, Christ must have been speaking to this woman who and says, let us make men in our
image
after our likeness. And there came up Adam, masculine, and Eve, feminine.
Amen.
Obviously, Eve must be an image of the Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, we see that they have always been together.
Yeah.
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 And let's look at another angle. Let's look at 1 John 5. 1 John 5. Verse 6.
Who is he that overcometh the world?
Yes.
But he that believeth that Christ is the Son of God.
Okay. The one that overcomes the world is one that believes that Christ
is the
Son of God.
Yeah.
Because there are so many people who are now refusing that. Okay?
Right. This is he that came by water and blood.
Christ came by water and blood. So do you see what Proverbs 8 says? She says in Proverbs 8, as one brought up together with Christ. And here, John is saying, Christ did not come alone, but came by water and blood. So what does the water stand for and the blood stand for?
Yeah.
Let's go to John chapter 7, verse 7.
In the last day,
the
great day of the feast, Jesus stood and cried, saying, if any man thirst, let him come to me and drink.
Yes.
He that believeth on me, as the scripture has said, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water. But this spake he of the Spirit, which they that believe on him should receive. For the Holy Ghost was not yet given, because that Jesus was not yet glorified.
So you see that Christ was speaking of the Holy Ghost, saying, out of his belly will flow rivers of
living waters.
So this living waters was representing the Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
So now, how he says, you spoke about this event because he hadn't been glorified. So when was he glorified? Let's look at John chapter 19, verse 34, and see whether this prophecy that he has said there was fulfilled.
But one of the soldiers with a spear pierced his side, and forthwith came there out blood and water.
Okay, so two streams were recorded to come from. When Adam was created, he was made to sleep, to a deep sleep, and a rib was removed from the side. So that was also a prophecy of what was to happen at the cross. When Christ also went into this deep sleep, because the righteous don't die, they sleep. So when he went into this deep sleep, what happened? The soldier pierced the side and two streams came out of water and the blood. Water representing the Holy Ghost. That was the scripture has said, isn't it? So now in 1 John chapter 5, it says, Christ did not come alone, but he came by water and blood. Blood stands for Christ. Water for the Holy Ghost. Now, it's clear from scriptures, we're not forgetting. John chapter 7 has told us the living waters is the Holy Ghost. And blood stands for Christ. Now, let's go back to 1 John 5, verse 7.
For there are three that bear record in heaven, the Father, the Word, and the Holy Ghost.
Okay, so in heaven we are told there are three that bear record. The Father, that's the eternal Father, and
the Word.
The Word, who is the Word? John chapter 1, verse 1, we know it by heaven. In the beginning was
the Word,
and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. And the Word came and dwelt, it became flesh and dwelt amongst us. And the world did not accept him, isn't it? So that was who? Christ. Isn't it? So the Word is Christ and
the Holy Ghost.
The Holy Ghost. So we have three members of the Godhead that bear record in heaven.
Yeah.
And their record is one.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we have the Father and two children.
Yeah.
Christ and the Holy Ghost, who are born twins.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes.
Just like Adam and Eve, on the same day, they are born twins.
Yes.
Yeah.
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 Eve came from the side. And the Holy Ghost is also shown to come from the side.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So we see that in heaven we have three. What about on earth? Let's go to verse 8.
And there are three.
Yes.
That bear witness in earth.
Right.
The Spirit.
The Spirit.
And the water.
The water.
And the blood.
And the blood.
And these three agree in one.
They also agree in one. So now we have, let's look at this scenario.
Yeah.
We have in heaven the Father.
Yeah.
And we have the Son.
Yeah.
And we have the daughter.
Yes.
Right?
Yeah.
And on earth, who do we have? When we have a father, automatically there must be
a mother. Yes.
Right?
Yeah.
To give birth to the children.
Mm-hmm.
Do you see that?
Yeah.
So we have a mother, the Spirit,
yeah.
And we have water, who is the Holy Ghost,
yes.
And we have blood, who is Christ.
Yeah.
So we have also, they've divided themselves that one parent is in heaven, with the children,
yeah.
And another parent is on earth with children.
Yeah.
Do you see that?
Yeah.
So the children, they are in both sections, heaven and
earth.
And on earth.
Yeah.
So in total now, how many people do we have? So we now have the Father in heaven,
right.
And we have on earth the Mother,
right.
The Spirit.
Yeah.
And then we have the Christ and the
Holy Ghost.
Yeah, yeah.
So two females on earth and two males in heaven.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's what John chapter 5 has told us.
Yes.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
So total, how many people?
Four.
Four members.
Yes.
Two males and two females.
Yes.
Yeah.
Do you see that?
Yeah.
The Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
So these are the four in the Godhead,
yeah.
And they represent that they are represented by Adam and Eve, male and female. Yeah. So in the Godhead we have male and female, and these two, Adam and Eve, they represent the two intercessors, the Holy Ghost and Christ.
Yes.
Now let's look at Romans chapter 6. Romans chapter 6, verse 26. Romans 6, verse 26.
Romans 6.
Yes.
Verse 26.
Yeah. Sorry, Romans 8. I mean Romans 8, verse 26.
Verse 26.
Yes.
Likewise,
mm-hmm.
The Spirit also helpeth our infirmities.
Yes.
For we know not what we should pray,
mm-hmm.
for as we ought,
mm-hmm.
But the Spirit itself maketh intercession,
mm-hmm.
for us with groanings which cannot be uttered.
Right. The Holy Ghost and the Holy Spirit, they are all Spirit. The Holy Ghost maketh intercession,
yeah.
with groanings that cannot be
uttered.
Yes.
So can you say that the Holy Ghost is an intercessor?
Yeah.
Just like Christ is our intercessor.
Yeah.
Let's see if it says that. Verse 34.
Verse 34.
Yes.
Who is he that condemneth?
Yeah.
It is Christ that died.
Yes.
He rather,
mm-hmm.
that is risen again.
Mm-hmm.
Who is even at the right hand of God.
Yeah.
Who also maketh intercession for us.
Uh-huh.
Who shall separate us?
Okay. So now we see Christ also intercedes together with the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
This is why when Christ ascended, as he was talking to the disciples, he promised that he would ask the Father to give us another comforter.
Yes.
So meaning that we have two comforters,
yeah.
two intercessors,
yeah.
two high priests for us.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yes.
Now, Let's look at why it is important to know this intercession and accept this intercession of two, the branch of Christ and the Holy Ghost.
Yes. Yeah.
Now let's go back to Proverbs 8 verse 32. Proverbs 8 verse 32.
Mm-hmm. Now therefore, hearken unto me,
yes,
O ye children,
mm-hmm,
for blessed are they that keep my ways.
Mm-hmm.
Hear instruction, mm-hmm, and be wise,
mm-hmm,
and refuse it not.
Mm-hmm.
Blessed is the man that heareth me, watching daily at my gates, mm-hmm, waiting the post of my doors.
Mm-hmm.
For whoso offendeth me, offendeth life.
Amen.
And shall be in favor of the Lord.
Amen. So this is why it's important. We all along knew about the intercession of Christ, but we never thought that the Holy Ghost also intercedes for us.
Yeah.
Right? We never thought that the Holy Ghost is our high priest.
Yeah.
Just like Christ is our high priest. So he says, she says, whosoever findeth me is found life. And what else? And shall obtain favor of the Lord.
Yes.
So if you accept the Holy Ghost as our intercessor, as our mother, we will find favor of the Lord. And we also find life.
Yeah.
Now, let's also go to Jeremiah chapter 23, verse 5 and 6.
Verse 5.
Yes.
Behold,
mm-hmm,
the day is come,
mm-hmm,
says the Lord, that I will raise unto David a righteous branch,
mm-hmm,
and a king shall reign and prosper,
mm-hmm,
and shall execute judgment,
mm-hmm,
and justice in the earth.
Yes.
In the days of Judah shall, mm-hmm, be saved,
mm-hmm,
and Israel shall dwell safely,
mm-hmm,
and this is the name whereby he shall be called the Lord our righteousness.
So Christ is the branch,
mm-hmm,
and as he intercedes for us,
yeah,
we'll call him as he transfers his righteousness to us.
Yeah.
When we see him, when we meet him, we'll call him the Lord,
our righteousness.
Yes. So we don't have our own righteousness. We must put on the righteousness of Christ, the branch.
Yes. Amen.
And let's look at the intercession of the Holy Ghost.
In those days, Jerusalem, and this is the name when she shall be called the Lord our righteousness.
She shall be called the Lord our righteousness.
Yes.
So she is our intercessor. She is interceding for us at the same time. This is why they instituted this service, that they be represented even in the services in the sanctuary, right?
Yeah.
Represented by the blood of animals,
yeah,
represented by the water,
mm-hmm,
represented by the oil.
Mm-hmm.
All these were representing their intercession.
Yeah.
Now, and we see that even amongst the animals, we see male animals being specified and female animals being required also.
Yes.
So these were representing our intercessors. Now, in the New Testament, we see also the bread and wine being mingled. Bread baked with olive oil, and oil stands for the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
And the wine being mingled with water,
yeah,
where water represents the Holy Spirit. We see that this intercession is of vital importance to us today. And if we dig deeper, we'll see what we need to have this water in our sanctuaries so that we are cleansed, so that we are healed from our sicknesses. This is why we need the bread and the wine for the sins to be forgiven, because the wages of sin is
death.
And so that we eat the body and the blood of Christ and to overcome. Now, we see that it is have been called the righteous branches.
Yeah.
So, meaning that these two, remember, we have been invited to their marriage.
Yeah.
Christ, God has invited us to the marriage of his son.
Yeah.
Right? Whom is Christ marrying?
Yeah.
Let's go to a great controversy, 426.2. 426 is commenting on Matthew 25, the 10 virgins. Can you start a little inside?
The coming.
Yes.
The coming of the bridegroom,
yeah,
here brought to view,
mm-hmm,
takes place before the marriage.
Yes.
The marriage represents the reception by Christ of his kingdom.
Right.
The holy city,
mm-hmm,
the New Jerusalem,
mm-hmm,
which is the capital and representative of the kingdom.
Right. Do you see that the holy city is called New Jerusalem?
Yeah.
But it is the representative of the
kingdom.
Of the kingdom.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
It's called the bride.
It's called the bride.
Amen.
The, yes, lamb's wife.
Yeah. And it's also called the lamb's
wife.
Now, we want to understand who is this bride and who is this lamb's wife.
Yeah.
Because we have been invited to the wedding.
Yeah.
But have we been invited to be the bride?
Yeah.
Okay.
Said the angel,
yeah,
to John,
yeah,
come hither,
mm-hmm,
I will show thee the bride,
mm-hmm,
the lamb's wife.
Mm-hmm.
He carried me away in the spirit,
mm-hmm,
and says,
mm-hmm,
the prophet showed me that great city,
mm-hmm,
the holy Jerusalem,
yes,
descending out of heaven from God.
Mm-hmm.
Clearly then, the bride represents the holy city, and the virgins that go out to meet the bridegroom are the symbol of the church.
Okay, so the bride represents the holy city.
Yeah.
So we have the bride, who is called the holy city,
yeah,
who is called New Jerusalem.
Mm-hmm.
Are we clear there?
Yes.
Who is also the representative of the kingdom.
Yeah.
Do you understand?
Yeah.
So, we also have virgins.
Yeah.
That have been invited to the marriage, to witness the,
yeah,
marriage,
yeah,
of the bride and the bridegroom.
Yeah.
Let's move on.
In the Revelation,
mm-hmm,
the people of God are said to be guests at the marriage supper.
So the people of God are invited as guests, isn't it?
Yeah.
So if you're invited as a guest, you just come to witness, isn't it?
Yeah.
You must expect to see the bridegroom and the bride.
Yeah.
Isn't it?
Yes.
Let's hear if this is the case.
If guests,
yeah,
they cannot be represented also as the bride.
Do you see that?
Yeah. Yeah.
If the church is there, the guests,
mm-hmm, yeah,
they can then turn to become the
bride.
The bride.
No.
No.
Yeah.
So there is a bride, a specific individual,
right,
who must wed with Christ.
Yes.
And we have seen all along in Proverbs that there is one who says, our daily is delight.
Amen.
And if you go to even Songs of Solomon, you will see you will see that it's actually Christ and the Holy Ghost. Okay,
yeah,
we'll look at that one soon. Yes, can you finish?
Christ,
uh-huh,
is stated by the prophet Daniel.
Okay, that, we have finished that one. So we see that Christ is the bridegroom,
yeah,
and the bride is the Holy Ghost. And we, a church is only invited to the wedding. Yes. So this is why it is very important to understand the plan of salvation, the double intercession that we have. Now, if you look at, just go to Songs of Solomon, just to confirm what we have just said. Songs of Solomon, chapter 4, verse 1. Songs of Solomon, chapter 4, verse 1. you can help. Songs of Solomon 4, verse 1.
Verse 1.
Mm-hmm.
Behold,
yes,
thou art fair.
Yes.
My love.
Yeah.
Behold, mm-hmm, thou art fair.
Yeah.
Thou hast doves,
mm-hmm,
eyes within thy locks.
So do you see that she's, it's, there's reference to the dove?
Yeah.
And the dove represents who?
The Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
Yes.
Thy hair is a flock of goats,
mm-hmm,
that appear from Mount Gilead.
Yes.
Thy teeth are like a flock of sheep,
mm-hmm,
that are even shorn,
mm-hmm,
which came up from the washing, the whereof everyone bear twins,
yeah,
and none is barren among them.
Talking of twins, and mm-hmm, they are also twins.
Yeah.
Yes.
Their lips,
mm-hmm,
are like a thread of scarlet.
Yes.
And thy speech is comely.
Mm-hmm.
Thy temples, mm-hmm, are like a piece of pomegranate,
mm-hmm,
within thy locks.
Yes.
Thy neck is like the Tower of David,
mm-hmm,
builded for an armory,
mm-hmm,
whereon they hang 1,000 bucklers,
mm-hmm,
and shields of mighty men.
Mm-hmm.
Thy two breasts are like two young roes,
mm-hmm,
that are twins,
mm-hmm,
which feed among the lilies.
Yes.
Until the daybreak,
mm-hmm,
and the shadows flee away,
mm-hmm,
I will get me to the mountain of might and to the hill of frankincense.
Mm-hmm.
Thou art all fair, my love,
mm-hmm,
there is no spot in thee.
Mm-hmm.
Come with me from Lebanon,
mm-hmm,
my spouse.
Mm-hmm.
With me from Lebanon,
mm-hmm,
look from the top of Amana,
mm-hmm,
from the top of Sheni,
mm-hmm,
and Hemon,
mm-hmm,
from the lion's dens,
mm-hmm,
from the mountains of the leopards. Thou hast ravished my heart,
mm-hmm,
my sister, my spouse.
Okay, do you see that, yeah. Christ says, thou have ravished my heart. Who? My sister, yeah, and also my spouse.
Yes. Amen.
So this is what they have been. They were created as twins, but they also are,
yeah,
going to marry.
Yeah.
So what type of a marriage? It's a holy marriage.
Yes.
Incorruptible marriage.
Yeah.
So my sister, my spouse.
Yeah.
Right? And if you look at, if you go to verse 7.
Verse 7.
Yeah.
Thou art all fair,
mm-hmm,
my love.
Mm-hmm.
There is no spot in thee.
Yes.
Come with me, mm-hmm, from Lebanon,
mm-hmm,
my spouse.
Mm-hmm.
With me from Lebanon.
Right.
Look from the top of Amana,
mm-hmm,
from the top of Sheni, mm-hmm, and Hemon.
Okay, go to verse 9.
Thou hast ravished my heart,
mm-hmm,
my sister, my spouse.
Okay. My spouse. Yeah.
Thou hast ravished my heart,
mm-hmm,
with one of thine eyes.
Yes.
Which one chain of thy neck.
Mm-hmm. No, okay. Now, we do see that this woman is called New Jerusalem.
Yeah.
And once we say New Jerusalem, it means there must have been an old Jerusalem.
Yeah.
Let's go to Galatians chapter 4, verse 26. Galatians 4, verse 26.
But Jerusalem,
uh-huh,
which is above,
uh-huh,
is free.
Yeah.
Which is the mother of us all.
Amen. Jerusalem, mm-hmm, which is above, is free, mm-hmm, which is the mother of us
all.
Oh.
Yeah.
So do you see that we have old Jerusalem and also we have new Jerusalem? Mm-hmm. So the Holy Ghost is represented as new Jerusalem. And why is it important that we know this? She says, those who have known me, who have accepted me, have received life.
Yeah.
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 Why is it important now to see and understand the intercession, this double intercession?
Yeah.
Because when we go to Revelation chapter 12, sorry, 3 verse 12. Revelation 3 verse 12. Yes.
I make a pillar in the temple of my God,
mm-hmm,
and he shall go no more out.
Yeah.
And I'll write upon him the name of my God.
Right.
And the name of the city of my God.
Right.
Which is New Jerusalem.
Amen.
Which cometh down out of heaven,
mm-hmm,
from my God.
Yeah.
And I'll write upon him my new name.
There you are.
Amen. Yes.
There, God is saying, if you overcome,
yeah, Yeah.
I'll write the name of God.
Yeah.
And I'll write the name of the
city
of my God, which is New Jerusalem. You have accepted the intercession of the branch she of the Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
So you also get the seal New Jerusalem. You have accepted to be a subject of New Jerusalem. Remember, we're told that Gabriel, the mighty angel, is in charge of Jerusalem.
Yeah.
So, if you accept the message of the kingdom of New Jerusalem, the kingdom being established under the intercession of the branch he and the branch she, then you receive
the seal,
New Jerusalem.
Amen.
The city where you are going.
Amen.
Yeah? And you also receive the new name of Christ, which is to do with his intercession.
Yeah.
Let's just to confirm that it is a new name which has to do with intercession. Let's read AA 595, I think point two. Yes.
Upon the foundation that Christ himself had laid, the apostles built the church of God.
Yeah.
In the scriptures, the figure of the erection of the temple is frequently used to illustrate the building of the church.
Yeah.
Zechariah refers to Christ as the branch
Amen.
That should be built the temple of the Lord.
So Zechariah refers to Christ as the
branch
that should build the temple of the Lord. And we have been told by Christ himself in Revelation 3 verse 12 that him that overcometh will I make a pillar in the temple of my God.
Yeah.
And I'll write upon them these three names.
Yeah.
So here we see that he has this name, branch. And when they wed, when they are a couple, they are also given one name, the family name, branch.
Amen.
This is why in Jeremiah 23, is Christ, he, our righteousness.
Yeah.
The branch, he, our righteousness. And the Holy Ghost is the branch, she, our righteousness.
Amen.
So they are a family. It's a family name, since heaven has a family. So God is warning us, messages for the sealing which is taking place now in our last days, that we accept the double intercession of the branch
Amen.
And be sealed for New Jerusalem. If you also take in Revelations, in Great Controversy 415.
We're studying the subject.
By one name, the family name, branch, Adam. They were called Adam when they were created. And we know that it is Adam who called his wife, woman.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
And he was blessed, overwhelmed to see a beautiful helpmeet. Right? Woman, and he also called him Eve to be the mother of all living, right?
Yeah.
Representing the Holy Ghost who is ever living, Right?
Amen.
And that's why today the Holy Ghost says, if you overcome, you receive new Jerusalem, the name of the ever-living woman who never died. What is the bride? He died as Christ.
Amen.
Right? But the Holy Spirit never died.
Yeah.
So, can you finish it off?
Says the prophet,
yes.
He shall build the temple of the Lord.
He shall build the temple of the Lord.
And he shall break the door and sit and draw upon his bottom.
Yeah.
And he shall be a priest of the Lord.
Yeah.
And the council of his
Lord. Yes. So, we are saying that this is the final name that should come on our forehead. We must receive God, New Jerusalem, and Jesus' new name. So how do we receive this? By settling into the truth of these three, God, New Jerusalem, and his new name. So this is something which is taking place in our mind. And we need to understand this and be sealed for the to understand these sealing truths and help us to every Sabbath as we receive these live presentations, we are receiving to settle into these truths for the kingdom. May we find this a pleasure to go through this and be finally sealed. May God bless the reading of his word.
Amen.
Bluetooth mode.